Now to bring us God's message this evening, I'm going to call on Johan for the message this afternoon. That's how this evening. Let's welcome Johan.
Amen. So good afternoon po. Ready po? Ready?
Ready.
Amen. So ready ko na yung mga gamit ko. Okay. So before we start, let's pray. Father God, again, thank you, Lord. We are grateful to you, Lord, for the opportunity, Lord, to be in church, Lord, to worship, Lord, to learn from you, Lord. We pray, Lord, that we will not take this for granted, Lord, but we treasure, Lord, times like this, Lord, that we can gather together, Lord, as a community, Lord, of believers. Father, we pray that you put our hearts together, Lord, as we learn this afternoon, Lord. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, ang ating pong title ng message natin ngayong gabi is Build Bridges, Not Walls. Okay? So, lagi natin naririnig to. It's kind of like a familiar title sa mga iba-ibang mga messages, or if you see quotations, these are kind of like familiar. So, tignan natin. Okay. Okay. So, sa meron po dito ng illustration or design ng bridge. For your information, this is the Bataan Cavite Bridge na ginagawa po ngayon, ano? They say it will be completed in 2029. So if you travel from Bataan to Cavite, it will take you 5-6 hours. But once this is built, this is 32 kilometers, it will take you, I think, 30 minutes or 50 minutes para makarating ka ng Cavite. You see, what a bridge does is it connects places, it connects people, it makes life easier for many, many people, di ba? But yung walls naman, walls can be good and bad, di ba? If you need protection, syempre, sa bahay mo, you put up walls. Pero, if you put up walls in relationships or especially in church, that's not a good thing. So mamaya po malalaman natin kung wall ba tayo o bridge tayo, okay? Okay, wall divides people while a bridge connects and unites people. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So, let's define the community. Kasi yung title po ng series na ito is Building a Christ-like Community. Na, Pastor? Okay, so ano community? A community is a unified body of individuals, a group of people with shared values and interests. Okay? Group of people tayo with shared values and interests. Christian values, di ba? A Christ-like community is characterized by love, forgiveness, shared commitment to serve one another. This is the important last part, okay? Regardless of our differences, huh? We are to love, we are to forgive, we are to serve one another regardless of our differences. Ito po yung sinasabing Christ-like community. Because no one is perfect. We will never be perfect. Pastor will never be perfect. Nang lahat po tayo, meron tayong mga kanya-kanyang baggages. Meron tayong mga weaknesses. So we just have to learn to love one another. Amen? Okay. A Christ-like community is composed of those who love Jesus and fellowship with each other. When the world, ito important, no? When the world sees the church in action, ano yung action na yun? No? That we love each other, that we serve each other. They should see the true love of Jesus and perhaps find themselves attracted to Christ too. This is our mission as believers. As we create a Christ-like community, we want others to see Jesus in us. Yung tunay na Jesus ang makita nila sa atin. Di ba? So that they will be attracted. No? Ito yung mission po natin. So, Colossians, balikan po natin yung mga, di ba? By committing to love, serve, and understand, and uplift one another, we can create an environment where everyone feels valued and included. No? Wala yung nafe-feel nila na out of place sila. Diba? Before, when we had friends, diba, we feel that we're OP. No? OP means out of place, right? So, hindi nila nararamdaman yun pag Christ-like yung community natin because we love and serve one another. Ultimately, reflecting the heart of Christ to the world around us. Okay? So, Colossians 3, 12, and 14. Sabi, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bear with each other, and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. And all over these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. It's not easy to forgive, but we were commanded to forgive as Christ forgave us. Amen? So, okay, dito tayo magkakaalaman. Okay? Here are the different generations po natin. Okay? Meron po po ditong builders generation, 1925 to 1945. Taas po ng kamay kung meron pa po. Wala na. Pass. Okay. Okay, next. Ito, matadami na po. I need you to be honest. I need to raise your hands. Okay? Baby boomers, 1946 to 1964. Taas ang kamay. Pang-inspect na po. Ushers, please. Okay, meron na. Di ba? Meron na. Okay? Kaya tayo, di ba? Hindi nagtaas na kami. Kaya tayo, di ba? Ay, taas. Birthday to eh. Di ba? Okay, Gen X, 1965 to 1979. Oh, madami na kami, eh. Hindi na natin kung sila nagbilang. Dapat ba nagbilang tayo, no? Okay. Generation Y, or the Millennials, 1980 to 1994. Ang konti na. Alam ko madami ito, eh. No? Eto siguro, Gen Z, represent 1995 to 2009. Ay, mga anak ko. Oh, dami ito. Ito, Gen Alpha. Ang dami mong generation na. Gen Alpha, 2010 to present, 2024. Bye, Pastor! Okay, so, makita po natin yung mga iba-ibang generation, no? So, nagkaalaman na po tayong lahat ngayong hapon na ito. Okay, ngayon naman, tingnan natin kung ano yung mga characteristics nito. So, binabasa ko ito, yung pinag-aaralan ko, oo nga, no, meron. Pero iba, parang hindi naman ganun yung, kunyari, baby boomer ka, sinasabing ganito ka, pero hindi lahat po ganito. Siguro, in their study, dun sa in-study nilang grupo, ito yung mga nakita po nila. Okay? So, baby boomers grew up during a time of economic prosperity and social change. They value hard work, loyalty, and face-to-face communication, often emphasize traditional values and stability. Tama po, ano? Mostly tama, di ba? So, anong strengths nila? Anong strength ng baby boomers? Ito po yung mga parents po natin, okay? So, experience, no? They have extensive life and work experience. Diba? They would provide you valuable insights and wisdom. Strong work ethic. Naalala ko, uncle ko at father ko, no? Hindi pwedeng tutulog-tulog, tatamaan ka. Talagang kailangan. Yung pala may pagtapos ng kumain, balik ka na sa work mo. Ganun. Ganun ka-strong kanilang work ethic. And then, networking skills. Magaling sila sa connection. No? Ang father ko, kahit di niya kilala si Esten, kinakausap niya. No? Ganun magaling ang networking skills ni daddy, ng mga baby boomers, no? Si Ate Marge, magaling connection, di ba? Okay. Medyo may hiyain po siya. Siguro pa ito Gen Z si Ate Marge, no?
Medyo.
Oh, medyo. Okay, Gen X naman tayo. Gen X, ito po yung aking generation. 1965 to 1979. So characteristics, experience significant social and economic shifts and the advent of personal computing. Dito po nagsimula yung mga computer, no? Yung mga malalaking computer pa nun. Known for their independence, adaptability, and skepticism. Value work balance. Tama din po, okay? So ano naman yung kanilang mga strength? Adaptability. So marunong sila mag-adapt. Independence, self-reliance, and resourceful. And then medyo practical din sila. They value authenticity, seek work-life balance, and prioritize quality alongside their careers. Next is millennials, or the Gen Y. Came of age during the rise of internet and social media, highly collaborative, valuing inclusivity and social consciousness, seek meaningful work experiences, and often favoring flexibility and innovation. So ang kanilang strength, tech savvy. Gumagaling na sa computer. Maraming, Marlon, ang generation ka ba, Marlon? Millennial ka?
Gen Z. Ha? Gen Z.
Uy! Millennial?
1980.
Oh, 80. So, millennial siya. Ito mo, very tech-savvy siya, no? Pag may problema kami sa computer, siya yung nakakagawa. And karamihan ng mga nag-aayos sa mga computer namin, mga itong mga generation na to. So, tech-savvy na nga sila. They're comfortable with technology and digital communication. Okay? Tapos, punta tayo susunod. Gen Z. Marami ito kanina, no? They are digital natives, no? Native na sa kanila yung technology. Pagmulat lang nila, may tablet na sa harap nila kaagad. Di ba? Ito po yung mga time na hindi pa natin alam yung masasamang effect ng tablet, yung blue light, di ba? When we were younger, pag pupunta kami sa mga children's party, dati-dati, pag umiyak ang anak mo, kakargahin mo, lalabas ka, padedegiin mo. Ito yung time na pag umiyak ng anak mo, oh, ayan, di ba? Ganon ka agad. So, yun yung naging pacifier ng mga bata. So, kaya, who have been exposed to technology at an early age, no? Even now, you see kids, as small kids, like, na pag inagaw niya, anong mangyari? Di ba? Yak na, okay? So, they emphasize diversity, inclusion, and mental health awareness. Okay? So often, entrepreneurial and socially conscious, seeking to make an impact. Totoo po ito. Marami po sa kanilang yon ang gagaling mag-isip ng business. So I have patients who would buy yung gummy bears sa SM for 65 pesos and then isi-sell nila sa school ng 125 pesos. No? Paano ka nakakabenta ng ganun? Di ba? Buti pa siya. Ang magagaling silang mag-innovate. Okay? Next is Gen Alpha, the youngest generation growing up in a technologically saturated environment. Okay, values will be likely shaped by the challenges and innovations of the 21st century. Ito, tingnan niyo, expected to be the most educated and technologically immersed. Tama nga naman siguro kasi yung technology every year, bago ng bago, di ba? So, na-adapt na doon mga kabataan po natin. Okay? Okay, tapos na po tayo dyan. Ito naman, masaya to. Gen Z terminologies. Are you familiar with their terminologies? Ako po hindi. Yung iba, hirap pa rin akong intindihin. Tignan natin, na-quiz tayo ba? Okay, ghosting. What does this mean? Ghosting. Ha? Ito ba yung pang-Halloween? Hindi po. Hindi po yung ganun to. Okay. Yan, nagpaparanda. Ghosting is a term common in the earlier talking stages of a relationship. Kunyari, nagkakilala, nagka-interest, and then biglang hindi na nag-text, hindi na nag-chat, hindi na tumawag. Naging multo na. No? Ito po yung ghosting. So, are you learning? Yes, halata yung mga ano, my baby boomers, yes! Okay, next is salty. Nakakataas ng blood pressure pag salty, no? Mahalat ang kinakain, pero hindi. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng salty? Pastor, guess, salty. Di ba alat? Halata. Salty, okay? Ibig sabihin ng salty is feeling jealous. No? Ang salty mo! Oh, right? So, ganun. Yung mga anak ko, parang naging cringy sila sa akin. Actually, they helped me with these terms. Okay, that's the way you own it. Okay, next would be... Cap! Yung may sombrero? Who wants to guess? Very easy ka. Oy! DNC! Diba? Cap means to lie. No? To lie. If you say no cap, it means you're being truthful. No cap. No, parang no cap. Totoo yung sinabi ko, no cap. Diba? Oh, pag sinabi, oh, your cap. Parang ganyan, sinungaling ka. Okay? So, next would be delulu. This is a funny word, delulu. Huh? Delulu. Nung una ko rin nanilig to, I was listening to a podcast and they're saying delulu. Hindi ko mag-gets, no? Hindi ko talaga naisip kung ano. Then, further research, delusional. No? Misdelusional. Naniniwala ka sa mga, kala mo totoo, pinipilit mo totoo itong bagay na to, pero hindi siya totoo. Di ba? So, delusional ka. So, is there anybody here who's delulu? Amen? So, I think this is the last. Tea! Let's have tea! Guess? Guess? Okay. Tea is gossip! How would you know it's gossip? Tea lang yan, di ba? Gossip or interesting news, often used in the phrase spill the tea. Labas mo ng chismis, di ba? Parang maritesto, di ba? So, why am I saying all these things? Because the older generation cannot connect with the younger generation. And then it would create a gap. No? Sinasadya man o hindi, nagkakaroon ng gap kasi hindi natin naiintindihan. You know what? I learned from my brother, si Bong. Si Bong is very patient. He's more patient than me. So, I was telling him one time, like, probably this was like 5 years ago, sabi ko, parang ganun yung mga youth ngayon. Sabi ko sa kanya, parang they don't show respect, they don't show interest. Tahimik lang sila sa isang sulok, no? Kasi before in our days, when an older person will come, you're gonna stand up, magbe-bless ka, lalapit ka, babati ka, ganun, di ba? But during that time, tahimik lang sa isang solo, minding his own phone or what, ganun lang. Like, my generation doesn't take it okay. Parang wala respect ng batang to. No? Yun pala, because these kids are kind of like exposed to tech, di ba? So, iba yung kanilang mindset. So, some say they have lower social skills. Kaya hindi na kasi na-develop yung social skills eh. Di ba? Hindi na sila yung, oh, punta ka doon, makipag-bless ka dyan, kamayan mo sila, makipag-kwentuhan ka. So, yun pala yung mga reason. So, I'm trying to be more patient sa mga ganitong bagay. No? I'm trying to be more understanding. Okay? So, meron na kayong mga alam na mga terminologies, ha? Okay, so, in spite of our differences, it is important to recognize that our differences can be a source of strength rather than division. Amen? Right? So, by embracing our unique perspective, gifts, talents, and experience, we can learn from one another and work towards our common goal. Right? Sometimes we judge people, like, bakit ganito siya magbihis, no? Bakit ganito yung style niya? Ha? Pero, maybe we're judging too much. So, kailangan iwasan din po natin yung mga ganung bagay. Okay? So, Ephesians 4:2 ang sabi, always be humble and gentle. Be patient with each other, making allowance for each other's faults because of your love. Now, being patient, di ba? Showing love will change the situation instead of arguing with one another. Do you agree? You know, mahirap talaga, di ba? That's why we should like, mag-adjust din po tayo. For my case, I grew up with a very strict father. Akala mo military, pero hindi siya military, no? So I kind of like adopted the strict discipline So, when my kids are growing up, parang strict din ako sa kanila. But then I heard the speaker, ang sabi, when your kids are young, you parent your kids. Diba? Pine-parent mo sila. That's how you set yung boundaries, yung discipline. But when they're older, probably around 12 years old, you start coaching them. Ah, oo nga, no? Diba? And you start coaching them. You start guiding them. Showing them how things are being done. Amen? So, dapat po pala ganun. Okay. And then, for us Christians, no, especially us, the older generation, the Bible tells us that we should be the light and the salt of the world. Okay? The light and the salt of the world. Set example to the younger generation, no, na makita nila what a Christian is all about, what being a Christian is all about. Because these younger kids are looking at us. Do I want to be a Christian just like my father, my mother, my uncle? Do I want to be a Christian just like the people in church? Are they being good examples to me? No? For us parents, who are we in church? And who are we in our house? Or sa work natin, sino tayo? Dapat we should reflect Christ-likeness. Okay? So ang sabi, make allowance, you know? And then, kanina, I mentioned the strengths and weaknesses of each generation. We can learn and grow together in spite of these weaknesses. Proverbs 27:17 says, as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens and influences another through discussion. Mag-usap tayo. Let's discuss things. Kung paano natin work out yung mga ganitong bagay. Diba? Instead of like, naiinis tayo, getting annoyed with the small things, instead of arguing, let's discuss. James 1:9, understand this, my beloved brothers and sisters, let everyone be quick to hear, be a careful, thoughtful listener, slow to speak, a speaker of carefully chosen words and slow to anger, patient, reflective, and forgiving. Napaka-detailed instruction, ano? Ang sabi, be a careful, thoughtful listener. Because most of us wants to speak right away, no? Without listening. Gusto natin ipagdalin yung point natin kaagad, no? I'm guilty of that to my kids, no? I'm trying to change. Slow to speak, no? Speaker of carefully chosen words. Choose your words because words can build walls. Amen? We don't want that. We don't want to build walls. Slow to anger. Patient, reflective, and forgiving. If you forgive, you display Christ-likeness, and people will see that. No, we all make mistakes. 1 Corinthians 12 and 13, the human body has many parts, but many parts make up one whole body. So it is the body of Christ. Some of us are Jews, some of us are Gentiles, some are slaves, and some are free. But we all have been baptized into the one body by one Spirit, and we all share the same Spirit. No? Different parts, but one body. So, to the younger generation, we need your energy. Diba? We need your minds, your skills, your tech skills, no? Your computer skills nyo. But I think you would also value and need our experience and wisdom and guidance to you. Okay? We can work together. Pwede po natin pagsamahin po ito para maging maganda yung takbo ng ating community. Maging Christ-like po tayo. So church, as I close, let me encourage you to reach out to someone of the older generation. Because sometimes, hindi na natin sila napapansin eh, di ba? Like, we only get together with our people the same age natin. So let's reach out. A simple hi, a simple kamusta, who make a big difference. We need to mentor them. I have a staff in the clinic. She is so hardworking. Talagang hardworking talaga. Talagang pagtrabaho, trabaho talaga. But she's missing, like, she's not good in communicating with people. So what will I do? Should I fire her? No. I would look at her strength, being a hard worker, and then slowly train her sa kanyang mga weakness. Ita-train natin siya. Baka naman mag-improve siya, di ba? Kung hindi siya mag-improve, edi dun lang siya. Kung ano yung strength niya, dun lang siya. She is still a valuable piece of our practice, no? Being a hard worker, which she is. Okay? So, let's value everyone's contribution. Okay? Again, encourage one another to build bridges, not walls. Our mission is to be Christ-like and share the gospel. This is our mission. Iba-iba ng culture, iba-iba ng year na pinaglakihan, iba-ibang tahanan. But then, this is our mission. Christ-likeness and to share the gospel. So now, are you a wall or a bridge? Bridge. No? So bridge po tayo. So, one body po tayo, we can impact the world. Or just Olongga po muna or Santa Rita for His glory. Okay? Sabi ni Isaac Newton, we build too many walls and not enough bridges. Diba? Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng conflict because kulang tayo sa mga bridges. This is Martin Luther King. Let's build bridges and not walls. Okay, sabi dun sa opening video ng Ben, diba? Together, we can be better. No, I believe that. You believe that we can be better together? Hindi kaya ni Pastor mag-isa, hindi kaya ni mga leaders niya mag-isa. But together, we can accomplish more for God. So, final verse. Don't be selfish. Don't try to impress others. Be humble. Thinking of others as better than yourselves. Don't look out only for your own interests, but take interest in others too. You must have the same attitude that Christ Jesus had. The same attitude. So in everything we do, let's have the same mindset and same attitude of Jesus. Amen. So let's close in prayer. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the reminder, Lord. The importance of unity, Lord, in our church. Help us to commit in building bridges and not walls. We pray, Lord, that our relationships, Lord, will foster, will reflect your love and grace, Lord. Guide us, Lord, as we embrace our differences, as we learn from one another, Lord. Salamat po, Lord. Empower us into your Holy Spirit, Lord, to be humble, to be patient, and to be kind to one another. Help us, Lord, to be peacemakers, Lord. We ask for your wisdom, Lord, and strength, Lord. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.